Welcome to the step-by-step tutorial on how to set up supply drivers in strategic workforce planning. Strategic workforce planning is a driver-based system that helps you ensure that you have a workforce with the right skills at the right time to support your organization's strategic objectives. With strategic workforce planning, you can proactively project future workforce trends and identify gaps in your workforce against your strategic goals. Let's define what drives our supply calculations. You need to select an attrition driver. If you enabled age-based retirement, then you can choose from two provided drivers, attrition by job or attrition by age. For age-based retirement, enter the expected or mandatory retirement age for your entity by year. Based on your historical trends, enter the expected attrition percentage per age band. You enter these values as negative numbers. You also enter attrition rates by job based on your historical trends as a negative number. After you enter your attrition rates, you calculate the supply. You need to select the total jobs member for this calculation. If we take a look at the supply FTE, we can see attrition factored in. In FY18, if we have 5 analysts with expected turnover of 10%, then our supply FTE is 4.5. That value then becomes the starting FTE value for FY19. So if we take no action, no transfers or new hires, then by the end of FY22, we expect to have 3 analysts remaining. Retirement can be factored in also. For example, we can see retirement factored into the director job. Review supply compensation, which is calculated based on the average compensation rates that were loaded, and the supply FTE. Based on the data entered, we can see that our total demand for the HR Service Desk US is higher than our expected supply. You can close this gap by transferring in employees or hiring new employees. In this tutorial, you saw how to set up supply drivers in strategic workforce planning. To learn more, visit cloud.oracle.com.